I'm in a prescribed burn in rural Idaho.
Starting sampling now.
Where a team of fire scientists are using a tricked out drone to hunt for life in the smoke. And what they discover could have big implications for our world and our health. Inside this cloud, amid all the dust and ash, are hundreds or even thousands of different bacteria and fungi. And these scientists studying them are part of an entirely new field of research called pyroaerobiology. It's so new that it didn't exist just a few years ago. And it came from a high school science fair project. This is Sarah Mims. She lives in San Antonio, Texas. And back in high school, she made an accidental discovery in her backyard. She'd set out microscope slides, trying to find dust that had traveled across the world. But instead, she found something unexpected.
When I was looking at those slides under the microscope, there were a large number of just solid black particles. And there were also a substantial number of fungal spores.
And it always seemed to happen on days when smoke was drifting in from crop fires in Mexico. Maybe, she thought, the fungal spores were coming from the smoke. After that, she went all in on this idea, whether microbes could live in smoke. So she designed a simple but clever experiment that I wanted to replicate myself. You take a petri film, it's a little sheet of paper that microbes like yeast and mold like to grow on, and you expose it to smoke from different types of burning yard waste. Then compare that to another petri film that's just exposed to normal air. After a few days, count the number of fungal colonies on each film. Those are these little blue circles all over the sheet. The blue dye indicates the presence of living microbes. The results? I found more than 10 times as many colonies on the film I exposed to the burning sticks than I did on the control. And Sarah's results were about the same.
I was very excited because that was just kind of confirming everything that I had found so far.
She and her dad published the study in a scientific journal, and her project ended up winning local and national awards. Then Sarah went to college and chose a different career path. And for years, the study just kind of sat there. About a decade later, a fire scientist, Lita Kobziar, was working on a prescribed burn, thinking about a story she'd read the night before, about people adding bacteria to snow machines to help form better snowflakes.
There's always time where you're standing around the fire just watching the smoke. So I just started to think about smoke kind of like the snow coming out of a snowmaking machine and wonder if there might be anything living in it.
After the burn, Lita searched for studies about microbes living in smoke. And all she could find was one study from 2003. Sarah's study. But the lone result made her curious.
I wasn't able to find anything else published about the idea, which was really shocking. I guess it just didn't get seen by enough microbiologists.
So Lita set out to build on Sarah's findings. Was there really life in the smoke? They tested smoke from prescribed burns on petri dishes and found microbes. They sampled smoke in different locations and temperatures, and they found microbes. They even went to a sterile indoor combustion lab, where there was nothing besides the burning material, and they found microbes.
We kind of tried all of the ways that we could shoot ourselves down, was what we tried, and the results have been unequivocal.
Smoke wasn't sterile. It was a whole world of microbes, fungi, and bacteria. But that discovery has raised more questions than answers. One of those questions? What this means for human health in a time of more frequent and severe wildfires. While scientists have a clear picture of the health impacts of smoke itself, how tiny smoke particles harm the lungs or the cardiovascular system, the health risks of bacterial or fungal infections from wildfire smoke remains a total mystery.
I get emails, you know, every couple of weeks just from firefighters, you know, how they had a strange infection after fire season. And I think there's a lot of stories like that out there that mean to me that it's really important to look into this and find out whether there's a link, because those are, you know, my brothers and sisters in fire.
And while plenty of fungi are harmless, some fungal illnesses can be life-threatening. Like valley fever. It's a disease caused by a fungus that grows in hot, dusty climates in the American West and travels on the wind. Cases have been rising in the past few decades. And scientists like Lita wonder whether wildfires in the West could play a role in its spread. Now, she's collaborating with four other labs across the nation on a major study trying to find answers to those big questions, both on a macro level, using epidemiology, and on a micro level, literally. Lita's lab is chasing wildfires and prescribed burns across the country, flying drones over the smoke plumes and collecting samples on filters. Then, in her DIY microbiology lab that she built out of a plastic tub, she preps the filters for analysis. Some will be sent to a lab in Florida, where they'll investigate what kind of microbes are in the smoke samples. They'll test for harmful microbes, like the kind that causes valley fever, and another team will see if any of the microbes within the smoke are actually potent enough to infect a lab animal. At the end of this multi-year study, they're hoping to get some answers to what, until now, has been a bit of a mystery. Pyroaerobiology is being built by people following their curiosities. For Sarah Mims, it was investigating those tiny black particles that showed up on her microscope slide. And for Lita, it was building on a decade-old science fair project with study after study until it became a whole field of research.
I think it's amazing that there's so much more to potentially be discovered. And I think it's great that it's actually being done now.
From here going forward, I already know that there are many other groups who are starting to do this work. And that's just so exciting. You know, it looks to me like a model of a tree, you know, that is just creating branches every day. And I think it's going to be pretty incredible what we discover going forward.
The end of a good day.
Absolutely.